Double Strix.
You got Lisa back there. We got Paul back there.
The beast of the earth, the drop of earth. Everything that creeps on the earth. Everything that has a breath of life. I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. And God saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. There was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day.
Back down to the front. Over the right side.
Chapter 2. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. And on the seventh day, God finished his work that he had done, and he rested on the seventh day from all his work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day, and made it holy, because on it God rested from all his work that he had done as creation.
To the back.
These are the generations of the heaven and the earth that were created, in the day that the Lord God made the earth and the heavens. When no bush of the field was yet in the land, and no small plant of the field had yet sprung up, for the Lord God had not caused it to rain on the land, and there was no man to work the ground, and a mist was going up from the land that was watering the whole face of the ground. Then the Lord God formed the man from dust from the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living creature. And the Lord God planted a garden in Eden, in the east, and there he put the man. Out of the ground, the Lord God made to spring up every tree that is pleasant to the sight, and good for food. The tree of life is in the midst of the garden, and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. A river flowed out of Eden to water the garden, and there it divided and became four rivers. The name of the first is the Pishon. It is the one that flowed around the whole land of Babylon where there is gold. The gold of that land is good. Gibeon and tonic stone are there. The name of the second river is Agion. It is the one that flowed around the whole land of Cush. The name of the third river is the Tigris, which flows east of Assyria. And the fourth river is the Euphrates. The Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work it and keep it. And the Lord God commanded the man, saying, you may surely eat of every tree in the garden, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat. For in the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die. Then the Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make for him a helper fit for him. Now I will grant the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every bird of the heavens, and brought him to the man to see what he would call them. And whenever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all the livestock and to the birds of the heavens and to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found a helper fit for him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall on the man while he slept, took one of his ribs, and closed up its place with flesh. The rib that the Lord God had taken from the man he made into a woman, and brought her to the man. Then the man said, this at last is bone of my bones, and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And the man and his wife were both naked, and were not ashamed. Chapter 3. Now the serpent was more crafty than any of the beasts of the field that the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, did God actually say, you shall not eat of any tree in the garden? And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the tree in the garden. But God said, you shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. But the serpent said to the woman, you will not surely die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil. So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband who was with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both were opened, and they knew that they were naked. They sewed fig leaves together and made themselves loincloths. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, and he said, I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked and I hid myself. He said, who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree of which I commanded you not to eat? The man said, well, the woman who you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit of the tree, and I ate. Then the Lord God said to the woman, what is this you have done? The woman said, the serpent deceived me, and I ate. The Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock, and above all beasts of the field. On your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and her, and between your offspring and her offspring. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. To the woman he said, I will surely multiply your pain in childbearing. In pain you shall bring forth children. Your desire shall be for your husband, and he shall rule over you. And to Adam he said, because you have listened to the voice of your wife and have eaten of the tree which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground because of you. In pain you shall eat it all the days of your life. Thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken. For you are dust, and to dust you shall return. The man called his wife's name Eve, because she was the mother of all living. And the Lord God made for Adam and for his wife garments of skins and clothes. Then the Lord God said, the man has become like one of us, knowing
good and evil.
Now, lest he reach out his hand and take also the tree of life and eat and live forever. Therefore, the Lord God sent him out from the garden of Eden to work the ground from which he was made. He drove out the man, and at the east of the garden of Eden, he placed a cherubim and a flaming sword that turned every way and barred the way to the tree of life. Chapter 4. Now Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bore children, saying, I have blessed the man with the help of the Lord. And again she bore his brother Abel. Now Abel was a keeper of sheep, and Cain a worker of the ground. In the course of time, Cain brought out to the Lord an offering of the fruit of the ground. Abel also brought out of the firstborn of his flock and of their fat portion. The Lord took regard to Abel and his offering. For Cain and his offering, he had no regard. And so Cain was very angry, and his face fell. The Lord said to Cain, why are you angry? And why is your face fallen? If you do well, you will be accepted. And if you do not do well, sin is crouching at the door. His desire is for you. He wants to rule over you. Cain spoke to Abel, his brother. When they were in the field, Cain rose up against his brother Abel and killed him. And the Lord said to Cain, where is Abel's brother? He said, I do not know. Am I my brother's keeper? And the Lord said, what have you done? The voice of your brother's blood is crying out from the ground. Now you are cursed from the ground, which has opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood on your hand. When you work the ground, you shall no longer yield to its strength. You shall be a fugitive and a wanderer on earth. Cain said to the Lord, my punishment is greater than I can bear.
Take time.
When Noah awoke from his wine and knew what his youngest son had done, brothers of King Canaan. The servant of servants shall he be to his brothers. He also said, Blessed be the Lord, the God of Shem, that Canaan be his servant. May God enlarge Jacob, and let him dwell in the tents of Shem, and let Canaan be his servant. After the flood, Noah lived 350 years. All the days of Noah were 950 years. He died.
Jack, drive that hip, hands are up. Drive that hip. Jack, drive that hip. Jack,
chapter
cross.
10.
Jack, cross.
These are the generations of the sons of Noah, Shem, Ham, and Jacob.
Stick with it. You don't
sons
find your
were
own.
Born to them after the flood.
Good.
The sons
nice.
Of Jacob,
Jack,
Gomer,
cross.
Magog,
Jack,
Madai, Jabin, Jubal, Meshach, and Tyrus.
The, three dogs. Oh.
The sons
good.
Of Gomer, Ashkenaz, Riphah, and Togarmah.
Hands are up.
Sons of Jabin, Elisha, Tarshish, Kittim, and Dodan. From these the coastland peoples spread in their lands, each with his own language, by their clans and their nations. The sons of Ham,
Cush,
Egypt,
Harut,
and Canaan.
Not this.
The sons of Cush, Seba, Havilah, Sabta, Raamah, and Sabtik. The sons of Raamah, Sheba, and
Dina.
Cush fathered Nimrod. He was the first on earth to be a mighty man. He was a mighty hunter before the Lord. Therefore it is said, like Nimrod, a mighty hunter before the Lord. The beginning of his kingdom was Babel, Erech, Akkad, and Calmath, land of Shinar. From that land he went into Assyria and built Nineveh, Rehoboth-ir, Calah, reasoning between Nineveh and Calah. That is the great city. Egypt fathered Ludum, Anam, Lehaven, Naphtuhem, Ethrusim, Aslan, from whom the Philistines came, and Kaphtorim.
Make a straight line.
Canaan fathered Sidon, his firstborn, and Heth, and the Jebusites, the Amorites, the Girgashites, the Hivites, the Argites, the Sinites, the Arvadites, the Zemarites, and the Hamathites. Afterward, the clans of the Canaanites dispersed, and the territory of the Canaanites extended from Sidon in the direction of Gerar as far as Gaza, and in the direction of Sodom, Gomorrah, Admah, and Zeboiim as far as Lashem.
You got it.
These are the sons of Ham by their clans, their languages, their lands, and their nations.
Hang in, everybody, we're almost done.
To Shem also, the father of all the children of Eber, the elder brother of Japheth, children were born. The sons of Shem, Elam, Asher, Arpachshad, Lud, and Aram. The sons of Aram, Uz, Bal, Ether, and Mash. Arpachshad fathered Shelah, and Shelah fathered Eber. To Eber were born two sons. The name of the one was Peleg, for in his days the earth was divided, and his brother's name was Joktan. Joktan fathered Amadad, Chilab, Hazarmaveth, Jira, Yoram, Uzal, Dikla, Obal, Abimael, Sheba, Ophir, Abila, and Jochad. All these were the sons of Joktan. The territory in which they lived extended from Mesha in the direction of Zephar to the hill country of the east. These are the sons of Shem by their clans, their languages, their lands, and their nations. These are the clans of the sons of Noah, according to their genealogies, in their nations. And from these, the nations spread abroad on the earth after the flood.
You know what's happening here? You'll have halves. Obliques. They'll have many punches.
Chapter 11. Now the whole earth had one language and the same word. And as people migrated from the east, they found a plain in the land of Shinar and settled there. And they said to Nahor took wives. The name of Abram's wife was Sarah. And the name of Nahor's wife, Milcah, the daughter of Haran, the father of Milcah and Iscah. Now Sarah was barren, and she had no child. Haran took Abram his son, and Lot the son of Haran his grandson, and Sarah his daughter-in-law, his son Abram's wife. And they went forth together from Ur of the Chaldeans to go into the land of Canaan. And when they came to Haran, they settled there. The days of Terah were 205 years, and Terah died in Haran. Chapter 12. Now the Lord said to Abram, go from your country and your kindred, your father's house, to the land that I will show you, and I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and him who dishonors you I will curse, and in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed. So Abram went as the Lord had told him, and Lot went with him. Abram was 75 years old when he departed from Haran. And Abram took Sarai his wife and Lot his brother's son, and all their possessions that they had gathered, and the people that they had acquired from Haran, and they set out to go to the land of Canaan. When they came to the land of Canaan, Abram passed through the land to the place at Shechem to the oak of Moreh. At that time the Canaanites were in the land. Then the Lord appeared to Abram and said, to your offspring I will give this land. So he built an altar to the Lord who had appeared to him. From there he moved to the hill country on the east of Bethel and pitched his tent, with Bethel on the west and Ai on the east. There he built an altar to the Lord and called upon the name of the Lord. And Abram journeyed on, still going toward the Negev. Now there was a famine in the land. So Abram went down to Egypt to sojourn there, for the famine was severe in the land. When he was about to enter Egypt, he said to Sarai, his wife, I know that you are a woman beautiful in appearance, and when the Egyptians see you, they will say, this is his wife. Then they will kill me, but they will let you live. Say you are my sister, that it may go well with me because of you, and that my life may be spared for your sake. When Abram entered Egypt, the Egyptians saw her, and the woman was very beautiful. And when the princes of Pharaoh saw her, they praised her to Pharaoh. And the woman was taken into Pharaoh's house. And for her sake he dealt well with Abram. And he had sheep, oxen, male donkeys, male servants, female servants, female donkeys, and camels. But the Lord afflicted Pharaoh and his house with great plagues because of Sarah, Abram's wife.
Come on.
So Pharaoh called Abram and said, what is this you have done to me? Why did you not tell me that she was your wife? Why did you say, she is my sister, so that I took her for my wife? Now then, here is your wife. Take her and go. And Pharaoh gave men orders concerning him, and they sent him away with his wife and all that he had. Chapter 13. So Abram went up from Egypt, he and his wife and all that he had, and Lot with him, into the Negev. Now Abram was very rich in livestock, in silver, and in gold. And he journeyed on from the Negev as far as Bethel, to the place where his tent had been at the beginning, between Bethel and Ai, to the place where he had made an altar at the first. And there Abram called on the name of the Lord. And Lot, who was with Abram, also had flocks and herds and tents, so that the land could not support both of them dwelling together. And their possessions were so great that they could not dwell together. And there was strife between the herdsmen of Abram's livestock and the herdsmen of Lot's livestock. At that time, the Canaanites and the Perizzites were dwelling in the land. Then Abram said to Lot, let there be no strife between you and me, between your herdsmen and my herdsmen, for we are kinsmen. Is not the whole land before you? Separate yourself from me. If you take the left hand, then I will go to the right. Or if you take the right hand, then I will go to the left. And Lot lifted up his eyes and saw that the Jordan Valley was well watered everywhere, like the garden of the Lord, like the land of Egypt in the direction of Zoar. This was before the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. So Lot chose for himself all the Jordan Valley. Lot journeyed east.
said.
The Lord said to Abram, after Lot had separated from him, lift up your eyes and look from the place where you are, northward and southward, eastward and westward.
Lift everything up.
For all the land that you see, I will give to you and your offspring forever.
Now their toes go
I will make your offspring as the dust of the earth, so that if one can count the dust of the earth, your offspring also can be counted.
Four,
your eyes walk through the length and the breadth of the land, for I will give it to you. So Abram moved his tent and came and settled by the oaks of Mamre, the son of Hebron.
There he built an altar to the Lord. Now there's a wide, chin off your chest, open up the knees, you're going to rock the feet.
Chapter 14.
Ready, go.
The days of Amraphel came to Kedar. Kedorlaomer king of Edom, the king of Goyim. Kings made war with Shinar, king of Edom. King of Goyim, and the king of Bela, Zoar. And all these joined forces in the valley of Siddim, that is, the Salt Sea. 12 years they fought Kedorlaomer, the 13th year they rebelled. In the 13th year, Kedorlaomer and the kings who were with him came and defeated the Rephaim, Ashtaroth, Phinehas, Azusa, Bethlehem, the Edomites, Sheba, Kiriathaim, and the Horites in their hill country of Seir as far as El Paran on the border of the wilderness. Then they turned back and came to En-Mishpat, that is Kadesh, and defeated all the country of the Amalekites and also the Amorites who were dwelling in Hazazon Tamar. Then the king of Sodom, the king of Gomorrah, the king of Adma, the king of Zeboah, and the king of Adma, that is Zoar, they joined battle in the valley of Siddim with Kedorlaomer, king of Elam, titled king of Goyim, Amraphel, king of Shinar, and Arioch, king of Elasar, four kings against five. Now the valley of Siddim was full of bitumen pits, and as the kings of Sodom and Gomorrah fled, some fell into them, and the rest fled to the hill country. So the enemy took all the possessions of Sodom and Gomorrah.